Okay, now let us look into the second problem of part A. Now second problem is also for minimization, where we have 5 cross 5 matrix, and hence the problem that is given to you is of balanced in nature. Now the first step is we pick up the minimum element from each row and subtract that particular minimum element from all elements of the matrix of that particular row. So you get this particular matrix. Now in this matrix, we check whether every column has got a single zero. Now when you closely observe this particular matrix, you have first column and the fifth column without any zero. So what you do is, you pick up the minimum element from the first column and subtract from all other elements. Similarly, you repeat for the fifth column, and this is what you get the matrix. Now this particular matrix, you will find presence of single zero, at least one zero in every row and every column. Now what you do in this matrix is you go for assignment. Pick up a row with one zero. So I have this particular row, so I'll mark this and I will cross this particular zero. Then I'll go to the second row, I have one zero here, I will cross this particular zero. Then I will go to the fifth row, I have one zero here, right? And then I have third row with two zeros. So what I do is I go column wise, I'll pick up the first zero and mark, and I will cross this particular zero. Now in this particular matrix, the total number of assigned cell is equal to 4, which is not equal to the order of the matrix, and hence this is not an optimal solution. We proceed for optimality. What we do is we now do the ticking business. Now in this particular ticking business, what we do is we tick a particular row where assignment is not made. So fourth row, assignment is not made. Now in this ticked row, we check whether we have any crossed zeros, which is in the third column. Now in the ticked column, we check whether there is an assignment made, which is in the first row. So we tick this particular row. Now in this particular ticked row, we check for crossed zeros, and we don't find any such cross zeros, and hence the ticking procedure is over. Now what we do is we draw the minimum number of lines in this particular matrix which will cover all the zeros. As you know, the minimum number of lines is drawn like this. The lines are drawn through all unmarked rows and marked columns. The second, third and the fifth row are unmarked rows, so we draw the line like this. So you'll see the green line, the line drawn on all unmarked rows and the marked columns, that is third column. And then we pick up the minimum element from all elements of this matrix where line is not passing. If you carefully observe, the minimum element is nothing but 2. Right? Now what we do with this minimum element is we add this minimum element at the intersection of two lines. Now this is the intersection of two lines, this one and this one. We add 2 at those particular cell which lies at the intersection of two lines. So 6 plus 2 is 8, 3 plus 2 is 5, 2 plus 2 is 4. Right? And then what we do is we subtract this minimum element 2 from all elements of the matrix where line is not passing. So 2 minus 2 is 0, 4 minus 2 is 2. Similarly, I'll get all other elements. Right? So I have filled up all elements. Now, don't touch any element which just lies where line is passing. Right? So do not disturb those elements. So I'll put this 0 here, I'll put this 0 here. Now this is my new matrix. Now if you carefully observe this matrix, the total number of zeros in this matrix is slightly more than number of zeros in this matrix. So we are proceeding towards optimality in the right direction. Now again in this particular matrix, we do the assignment business once again. We pick up a row with one zero. So I have second row with one zero. I mark assignment here. I cross out this particular column. Then I have fourth row, I do like this, I cross out this, and then I have fifth row, that is also fine. Then I have first row, I'll do like this, and I cross out this, and I have fifth row, I cross out this. Right? Now when you closely observe this particular matrix, I have total number of assignment made, which is equal to 5. And this number of assignments is equal to the order of the matrix, and hence we have obtained the optimal solution. And the optimal assignment will be like this. Now this is the first one. So you have T1, S1, then you have T2, S4, similarly T3, S5, T4, S3, and T5, S2. And then optimal solution is, so go back to the cost effectiveness matrix. I have 11 plus 6 plus 16 plus 17 plus 10. So 17, 60. So the optimal assignment or the optimal solution for this assignment problem is 60.